Amagyanatimarandasya gyananjanashalakaya chaksurunmilitanyena tasmai shri gurave namaha. Nama om Vishnu padaya Krishna prestaya bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti namane. Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Precharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschacha Desha Tarine Vancha Kaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha. Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we are studying Srimad Bhagavatam. And we're on the fifth canto, the final chapter of the fifth canto. It's chapter number 26. And we're on text number 21. And we're hearing Sukadeva Goswami is describing to Maharaj Parikshit about different kinds of hell, different, because he's already he's describing different kinds of hell.
我们学习的是圣典国家瓦坛第五篇第二十六章，也就是最后一章。这里是对地狱星球的描述。我们上一次学到的是第二十一师节，是Sukadeva Goswami 给 Parikshita 王讲述的不同的地狱星球。And
Sukadeva Goswami had described about all the different planets in the universe, upper planets and the middle earthly planets, and now he's come down into the lower region of the universe. He's come to the bottom where Yamaraj has his planet.
Sukadeva Goswami 给我们描述了整个宇宙的这个星系，有 地球之上的这七个星球，有中间的地球星球，还有下面的这个星球，现在来到了这个宇宙的底部 ，Yamaraj 所在的这个地狱星球。So,
you know, when we hear about all of these different hells, we will naturally become, it's not very pleasant. We will become disturbed that maybe I will have to go to these hells because I'm a sinful person.
当我们聆听到关于这些不同的地狱星球的描述的时候，我们的内心可能并不感觉到舒服或者受到打扰。我们有可能也会想，有可能我也这么的罪恶，以至于我也要可能去到这些地狱星球上去。So
we will see how Maharaj Parikshit, after hearing about all these hells, just a minute. After hearing about all of these different hells, he wants to know, how can people be saved from these hells? What can we do to save people from going to these hells?
Sukadeva Goswami 给我们描述了这些不同的地狱星球之后， Maharaj Parikshita 他就会也会思考，就是说，关于对于我们来说，我们要如何保证我们的安全，不去到这样的地狱星球上去。So
that's the subject matter which is coming in the next canto, canto 6. We'll hear about the chanting of the holy name.
圣典波迦瓦第六篇的主题，我们要开始唱诵主的圣名。And
we will hear how by chanting the holy name we can be saved from all kinds of sinful reactions.
们是如何通过唱颂主的圣名来避免所有的这些罪恶活动的反应的。
The power of the holy name is so great that it can destroy unlimited amounts of sin.
主的圣名是如此的有力量，它可以摧毁掉一个人无限的罪恶。
All right, so we'll continue here about more of these hellish planets. There's a lot of hellish planets, all different kinds of hells.
好，我们现在就来聆听这些不同的这些地狱的这些星球。
So the next text describes about people who they're so perverted, they're so low that they want to have sex, and they will even have sex with animals.
在第二十一世界就描述的一个人是如此的低等，他甚至想和一个动物发生性行为。
So these kind of people, they go to a hell where their bodies are ripped apart with thorns on the tree. There's a tree full of thorns, and they're forced to hang from that tree and be ripped, have the body ripped by all the thorns on the tree.
在这个地狱里面有一棵树，而这个树上面长满了像霹雳非常尖的刺的那种树，那个树上面全都是这样很尖的这种刺，人不得不被这个树所刺到。
So, you know, sometimes people are so, their sex desire is so strong that they cannot get the satisfaction they want with the people, and they turn to animals to try to have sex.
有一些人他的性欲是如此的强烈，以至于他甚至把这种性欲的目标从人类转向与动物发生这种性的生活。
We may not believe it, but it's there are people like that. They're so fallen.
我们或许不相信这样的事情发生，但是这样的事情确实发生着，他们是非常的堕落的。
And just as there are people who do these sinful things, there are also hells for these people, where they suffer.
当这些人从事这些罪恶的时候，同时也有这样的地狱会为他们准备着。
We may not believe.People could be so fallen, but it happens. It's actually like that.
我们可能不相信有人会如此的堕落，但是这个事情确实发生着。
So sometimes somebody is put into a very good family. They may be put in a nice, very wealthy, a very aristocratic family, but.Then they don't do anything. They become very degraded, and they don't follow any of the religious principles.
有一些人他诞生在比较高等的这种家庭，或者有规律、有原则的这种家庭，但是他们却非常的堕落。
So that person who is like that, he's put into a there's a river which is around hell.And he's put into that river, and that river is full of all kinds of ferocious creatures.
这种由此变得堕落的人，在死后将会进入到一个地狱之河中。这个河环绕着地狱的护城河，里面充满着这些凶猛的水栖的动物。
So these creatures who are living in that river, they begin to eat that man, but because the man.He only has a subtle body. He has to experience all the pain of being eaten by these different animals.
在这个，当这个人去到这个地方的时，去到这样的地狱的时候，这里面的水生物就立刻就要开始吃他。虽然他没有这个躯体，但是他还有这个精微的躯体。他无法逃离这个躯体，那些水生物就一直不停地吃他的这个躯体。
So he remembers all of his sinful activities, and he suffers terribly.
他不断地记起他的这些罪恶活动，而且也不一直不停地在受着苦。
Then there are people who are born in low families, they're very low born, and they live like animals. They have no good behavior, they're not clean, they have no good qualities. So these people, they cannot, they, when they die, they are put into another kind of hell.
这些人当他们死后, 他们会去到, 他们会被投入到另外一个地狱。
And they're put into this kind of river which is full of all horrible things, and they have to eat the horrible things which are in the river.
他们会被投入到一条河流里面, 而这个河流里面充满着这些恐怖的东西, 他又不得不去吃那些很可怕的东西。
So sometimes people, they become very attached to doing karmakanda or jnanakanda. You know, karmakanda means to do activities to enjoy the material world or to get liberation, and they don't understand the real goal of life.
有一些人他们追随的是karmakanda, 或者说jnanakanda, 业报活动, 或者说心智推敲的这种道路, 他们由此而 迷失了人生的真正的目标。
And so that person, he can also have, may have to go to hell and eat all kinds of horrible things.
这些人他们也有可能会被投入到地狱去吃这些很厌恶的东西。
So now this verse is talking about people born sudras. So in the Kali Yuga, we're all born sudras.
在这节诗里面谈到的是那些书者，他们出生在书者的这些家庭的人，但是在卡利年代，我们所有人其实都是书者。And
we can, because we're born in these low conditions, in the next life we may have to go to that hell.
因为我们出生在这种状况下，有可能我们就会去到那样的地狱。
But although we're born sudras, we're not meant to remain sudras. We're meant to become brahmanas. Human life is meant for improvement. We should become brahmanas.
虽然我们出生在sudra，但是我们不一定可以，不一定一直保持着这个sudra的身份。人体的生命就是不断的能够让我们获得提升。人体的生命是被应该被提升到 brahmana polamana 阶层的状态。
Maybe our qualification is sudra, but we should not, we should try to improve, we should not remain sudra.
Right.
We take birth in a low position, doesn't mean we have to remain in that low position.
我们出生在低等的位置上。
We should come. We should become devotees, and then we can. Then we will be naturally. We'll be brahmanas.
We should become.
So this is the purpose of our Krishna consciousness movement, to help people to become, to come to the platform of devotees.
This is the purpose of our Krishna consciousness movement.
In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna told Arjuna to give up all of his material duties and surrender to him. So we should give up the duty of being a sudra or a vaishya or a kshatriya and just become a devotee. Right. And one who is a devotee, he's naturally a brahmana. Then we can use the human life to go back home, back to Godhead.
It
doesn't matter if we are low born by birth, or if we're women, or sudra, or vaishya. Everybody can become Krishna conscious.
不在乎我们到底是书者, vaisha, 或者说叉叉, 每一个人都可以回归守身。
But if you're satisfied to be a sudra, then you may have to go to this hell which is described here.
但如果一个人很满足于他输着的这个地位的话，他就得去到我们刚刚所描述的这个地狱的状况之中。
Now, somebody may be born, they may be very high class. They're born in a good family like a Brahmin, Kshatriya or Vaishya, but they may be very attached of pet dogs.
有一些人，如果他出生在高等阶层的人，比如说婆罗门、叉垂啊、歪舍，但是他非常依附他的宠物，比如说狗。
Or sometimes he goes to the forest to hunt animals.
或者他有时候去到森林里面去打猎。
So there's a special hell where he goes.
也会有一个很特别的地狱，给他准备的。
There, Yamaraj has his servants, and his servants, they use that person for the target, and they pierce him with arrows. They fire arrows into his body, because he used to fire arrows into the body of animals. So when he goes to hell, they fire arrows into him.
Yamaraj 和他的助手们也会把这个人当作靶子一样用箭射穿他。
So people who are born in good families, they should cultivate knowledge about what is Brahman. They should understand what is matter and what is spirit.
出生在高等阶层的人，他们应该培养 Brahman 的知识。他们应该知道什么是凡，什么是物质，什么是灵性的。
But if they just use their time to hunt animals,then they're punished by going to this hell.
如果他们只是用时间去打猎的话，他们就会在这样的地狱里面遭受惩罚。
And there they get pierced with arrows or they get put into hellish conditions.
他们会被用箭射穿，然后去到这种被投入到很地狱的状况之中。
Then somebody may be very proud.Of his position in the material world, and he may do animal sacrifices, so he also goes to hell.
如果有人为自己的地位而感到骄傲，他们满不在乎的去拿动物做祭祀、牺牲动物的话，他们也会被投入到地狱之中。
The servants of Yamaraj kill him. First of all, they give him a lot of pain, and then they kill him, just like he gave pain to the animals, and then he killed them. So they give him pain, and then they kill him.
Yamaraj 和他的助手们就会给这个人无限的痛苦，然后杀死他，就像他在之前给予那些动物带来痛苦，然后杀死他一样。Yamaraj 和他的助手们也会给这个人带来痛苦，然后再杀死他。
So in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna describes somebody may have practiced yoga in their previous life, but not successful.
在《薄伽梵歌》中，主 Krishna 说，有一些人他以前学习过Bhakti 奉爱瑜伽。但是并没有成功。
So he may be put into next life. He's born in a wealthy family or a Brahmana family.
因此，在下一生的时候，他也许会被投身在一个 Brahmana family 家庭之中，或者说一个富裕的家庭之中。
But often these people they get bad association and they forget about the real purpose of life, and they just go after sense gratification.
通常情况下，这些人由于不良的这种涟漪，他们忘记了自己的生，忘记了自己的地位和身份，然后又开始回到感官享乐的路上去。
They do sacrifices for demigods like Kali or Durga, and they kill animals in the name of religion.
他们会做动物的祭祀，他们给卡利做这种动物的祭祀，然后杀掉这些动物。
So these people, because when they do these yagyas, they will make some mistakes, and then they will get sinful reactions. They have to go to hell.
因为他们做这种动物祭祀，有时候他们是在犯错，在结束的时候，他们就会去到地狱。
And Prabhupada said in Calcutta, there's many slaughterhouses.Where animal flesh, they sell animal flesh, And they tell people, this is the flesh from that was sacrificed to Goddess Kali.
圣帕帕德在这里说, 在加尔各达有很多屠宰场, 他们出售的一些肉, 他们说这个肉是在卡利面前, 卡利女神面前, 祭祀供奉的这些动物肉。
Actually, the Shastra say, once in a month, on a dark moon night, once in a month, it means once in a month, because dark moon night is only once in a month, that time you can sacrifice a goat to Goddess Kali.
在经典中说, 每个月只有一次, 也就是在, 在黑夜的这个月亮全部黑的这个时候, 你才能够 给在卡利面,
There's nowhere where it said every day you can kill the animals and just sell them.
从来没有哪一个里面说, 你可以每一天去杀这个动物, 然后可以去卖掉这些动物肉。
Yeah, you can't just keep a slaughterhouse and kill the animals when you feel like it.
而这些, 你不能说这个, 这个屠宰场保持着这些动物就是很正确的，不是的。So
sometimes somebody's born in a good family, but he forces his wife to drink his semen because he's so lusty to keep her under his control.
有一些人他出生在二次诞生的这个家庭比较高等的这种家庭，但是他强迫他的妻子，由于太
So he's put into a river, which is a flowing river of semen, and he's forced to drink that.
在死后，他被扔进一条流动的精液之河, 在那里被迫喝河水之中的精液。
So this kind of thing is done by people who are very degraded, very lusty.
这些人 做这种行为的这些人是非常充满色欲、非常低等的这些人。
Only very low class men would do this kind of thing. It's a very black, very, very terrible, horrible thing.
只有低等阶层的人才从事这样肮脏的这种行径。这些行为非常可怕、可憎。
So if a man does this, he goes to a special hell where he suffers a lot.
如果一个人做这个事情的话，他会被投入到一个地狱星球之中。
And some people, they set fire to people's houses and they give poison to them.
还有一些人，他们是职业的抢劫犯，他们甚至或者像其他的人投毒。
And sometimes they get businessmen to pay income tax, they get them to, they take away all their money from people who do business.
还有一些人，他们靠强迫这些商人交纳收入、交纳税收和其他的方法来抢劫他们。
So these people, they go to a planet where there are 720 dogs, and all the dogs have very strong teeth.
这些人在死后，他们会被投入到一个星球。这个地狱星球有720条狗，每一条狗的牙齿像霹雳一样尖有力。And
these dogs, they will eat the sinful people.
这些狗就会吃掉这些罪恶的。So
in the Kali Yuga, people will be there will be shortage of three. There will be shortage of rain. There will be hunger. And you have to pay a lot of taxes to the government. Three big problems.
在卡利年代，人们有三个比较大的问题： 雨水匮乏， 饥饿， 以及沉重的税收。
We can see here in Mayapur now, it has not rained for about 3 months, not one drop.
我们可以在马亚普看到，已经有三个月没有下雨。
Not one drop, not even a little.
三个月内没有一滴的雨水。So,
and then, because people have no work, they have no job, because of the COVID, the virus, many people are hungry, they cannot get food.
因为人们没有工作，而且也由于这个疫情的这个原因，很多人 都处于饥饿的边缘。
And the government, they want tax. Pay the taxes. Pay the money to the government.
而且还有这个政府的官员找他们来收纳税收。
And so it's just so much suffering in the material world.
因此，在这个物质世界充满了很多的困难。
The government will try to get the business people to pay more money, to give more money in taxes.
这些政府官员想让这些从事生意的人，想让他们付更多的税收。
And these people in the government are often thieves. They just want to take the money from the innocent people.
这样的一些政府官员，他们就像贼一样，他们就是想从这些人，从这些无辜的人那里拿钱。
So somebody may rob people on the street, and somebody else may be the government worker. He may rob people. They both get punished.
不管是在高速公路上的这些强盗，还是在政府里面的官员的这些强盗，他们都会被投入到地狱中受惩罚。
And the suffering is they get bitten by all these dogs.
他们所遭受的惩罚就是会被这些狗所咬。
And somebody else, they tell lies when doing business.
有一些人他们在做生意的时候会说谎。
Or he may even be giving charity, but he's telling lies.
或者他在布施的时候会撒谎。
So they get punished also by Yamaraj.
他也会被 Yamaraj 所惩罚。
He's taken to the top of a mountain, very high mountain, many miles high, hundreds of miles high, and they throw him head first into the hell.
他会被带到一个很高很高的这个山巅上，几百英里高的山巅上，然后头朝下的被扔到地狱之中。
And they're thrown into this.They're thrown into what looks like an ocean, but it's just stone. It's all stone, hard stone. So the man falls down from the mountain into the stone. His body is broken to pieces.
他被从就是头朝下的，他被扔到这个地狱。这个地狱没有任何的，看起来这个地狱的这个表面像波浪一样，实际上是波浪一样的这些坚硬的石头。所以他头朝下被扔下来的时候。头被击得粉碎。
And they throw him again and again. They throw him down. He doesn't die, but he just suffers again and again.
他不会被这样砸死，但是他一遍又一遍的被从山上扔下来。
And if a brahmana or the wife of a brahmana, if they drink alcohol, then they also go to hell.
如果一个婆罗门或者说婆罗门的妻子他去喝酒的话，他也会被投入到地狱之中。
Even if it doesn't matter, you may not be a brahmana, you may be a kshatriya or a vaishya, anybody. But if they drink this liquor, then they can go to hell.
无论他是婆罗门，还是沙帝利，还是说vaishya，只要他是喝这种酒一样的液体，他就有可能会去到地狱。
So some people are Brahmana in name only, and they do sinful things.
有一些人只是名义上的婆罗门，但是他从事着各种各样的罪恶活动。
And if they don't follow the principles, what they're supposed to do, then they go to hell, and they have to drink this very hot liquid. Burns. They pour this boiling hot liquid into them.
如果他们不遵循这些规范原则，他们做这样的一些事情的话，他们就会去到地狱。他们最后会喝这种赤融化的铁水，就是炽热的融化的铁水倒进他们的口中。
And another kind of person, who is very terrible person, he's very proud. He thinks I am very great, and he does not show proper respect to other people.
如果有一些人认为我非常的伟大，而且根本不对那些比他自己年长的人有任何的尊敬的话，这样的一些人
，people may be more austere or better birth, better educated, but he does not respect them.
这些人如果比那些比他更苦行、更易受教育、行为举止更好的人，如果他不对这些人表示尊敬的话。
So he's just like a dead man. Even though he's living, he's like dead.
这样的人，即便他活着，实际上是死了。
And so he's also put into hell. He suffers.
他也会去到地狱。
So we should never be proud. We should always be humble.
因此，我们永远不要骄傲。我们应该保持，永远保持谦卑。
We should show respect to people who are more elevated.We're more advanced. We should give them respect.
我们应该比那些比我们更精进的人，永远对他们表示尊敬。
If we don't, we get punished.
如果我们不这样做的话，我们就会遭受惩罚。
So there's also people who sacrifice other human beings to demigods like Kali, and then they eat.The person's flesh, after they sacrifice the person to the goddess, they will eat that person's flesh.
还有一些人，他们把人当作祭祀，供奉给卡利女神。供奉完之后，他们吃这些人的鲜血鲜肉。
So people who do this, they're taken to Yamaraj, and they're their victims. Their victim, the people who they ate, they become.Rakshasas and they cut them to pieces.
这些人在死后也被带到 Yamaraj 的居所，在那里，那些曾经被他们所祭祀、所牺牲的这些人会化身为 Rakshas， 然后把他劈成一片一片，剁成碎片。
And just like before, the person was drinking their blood. This time, these people come back to drink their blood.
就像先前这个罪恶的人吃别人的鲜血先喝他的鲜血一样，这一次他在地狱的时候，这些人也会来喝他的鲜血。
Then sometimes animals and birds, they come to get protection, and they come and they take shelter of people.
有些时候一些鸟他会来到人们面前寻求人们的庇护。
But the people actually pierce them they pierce them with some metal rod and they play with them like toys and they give them so much pain.
但是人这些鸟和动物来到人们面前，人们却把这个鸟和动物像玩具一样在玩耍，或者用线刺穿它们。
So they get the same suffering back when they go to hell.
当这个罪恶的人死后，他也会遭受同样的痛苦。
And birds like vultures come and eat them. They have very sharp beaks and they come and tear their bodies to pieces and eat them.
当他们死后去到这个地狱的时候，秃鹰、苍鹫就会来用他们很尖的这个嘴也来袭击吃他们。
So they remember about how they did sinful activities in their past.
这样他们就会想起自己过去所做的罪恶的活动。
And some people they're very envious and always angry and very good, give a lot of pain to others. They also go to hell.
有一些人他总是很愤怒，或者像蛇一样在嫉妒别人，他也会去到地狱。
And in that hell, there are these snakes which have five heads, and these snakes eat these sinful people.
在这个地狱之中，有长着五个头的这样的蛇会吃这样罪恶的人。
And sometimes people they keep other living entities, they keep them in a cave or they keep them in a well.They torture them, keep them in these restricted places.
有一些人把动物关在一个黑井里面或者一个山洞里面。
So when they die, they also get put into a well and they also suffer, just like they tortured these animals.
因此当他死后他也会被送到黑井，或者说这样的很黑井之中，就像他之前对其他生物所做的那些行为一样。
And if somebody is a householder and he may get guests coming to his home, he may get visitors, but he's not nice to them and he looks at them in an angry mood.
如果一个人是居士，他对那些拜访者总是以一种很愤怒的心态，以很不好的心情去接受他们的话，接待他们的话。
So that person goes to a special hell where there are these birds, and these birds will come, and the birds will come down, they'll pluck out the person's eyes.
当他死后去到地狱，他也会被这些鸟，然后这些鸟就盯着他。突然之间这个鸟就扑下来吃他的眼睛。
So Vedic culture is to receive even an enemy when he comes to your home. You should receive him in such a nice way. Make him happy, make him comfortable.
根据伟达文化，即便是一个敌人来到居士的家里，我们应该以很温和的很好的方式接待这个敌人。
But if you look at him in a bad way,then it's very offensive and you have to suffer in hell.
如果我们以一种很不好的方式去看待这个拜访者的话，在死后我们也会被投入到地狱。
And if somebody's got a lot of wealth and he's thinking, I'm so rich, nobody is equal to me, then he's also got problems.
如果有人他得了有很多的财富，然后他总是认为没有人和我平等，我有这么多的钱，他也会有麻烦，有问题。
He's always worried somebody will take his money.
他总是担心别人会拿他的钱。
So his heart is always dry, think worrying about losing his money.
因此他的内心总是很干枯的，总是担心着别人会拿他的钱。
So he doesn't get any real happiness, he doesn't know what to be done, how to get free of anxiety. So he's put into hell, where Yamaraj punishes him, he runs his needle through his body, just like you stitch a cloth.
他也会被投入到地狱，在那里 Yamaraj 的这些官员们像织布工织布一样用针线把他全身给缝一遍，惩罚他。
Yeah, if somebody's got more money than necessary, then he'll become very proud.
如果一个人拥有超过他所需要的钱财，他一定会变得骄傲。
So this is what happens in the world today.
这就是当今所发生的这一切。
A Brahmana, he should not have anything.
一个婆罗门不应该有任何的东西。
The Kshatriya, he can have some wealth, but only for performing sacrifice to do yagya.
而一个 Kshatriya, 他可以拥有财富，但他的财富只是为了举行伟达经典中的这些祭祀而已。
And the Vaishya, he earns money honestly by doing farming and cow protection or some business.
一个 Vaishya 也可以诚实的去赚钱，他可以通过农业保护母牛或者某一些贸易去诚实的赚钱。
But if a Sudra gets money, he doesn't know how to spend it properly.
如果一个 Sudra 有了钱，他根本就不知道怎么样恰当的去用这些钱。
In the Kali Yuga, there's no qualified Brahmin. Everybody is a Sudra.
在卡尼年代，没有合格的婆罗门，每一个人都是 Sudra。
Sudras don't know how to use money properly. They don't know how to spend money for Krishna.
Sudra 根本不知道怎么样恰当的用钱，他也不知道怎么样把钱用于 Krishna 的服务之中。
Money is Lakshmi, and Lakshmi is always the servant of Lord Narayan.
钱也被称为 Lakshmi, Lakshmi 总是在服务着主 Narayan。
So wherever there's money, it should be used for the service of Lord Narayan.
哪里有钱，那个钱就应该用于服务 Narayan.
So everybody should use their money to serve the Krishna consciousness movement.
因此每个人都应该用钱用于传服务 Krishna 之学。
And if we just keep money, we'll just become proud and then we'll do sinful activities.
如果我们只是存钱的话，我们一定会骄傲，而且会从事罪恶的活动。
Money, it all belongs to Krishna. It's meant to be used for his service.
钱实际上是属于 Krishna, 应该用于对 Krishna 的服务之中。
So we have money, we have more than we need, we should give it to Krishna.
如果我们有钱，有超过我们所需的钱，我们应该把这个钱给予 Krishna.
If we don't, then we just become proud, we become puffed up.
如果我们不这样做的话，我们就会变得骄傲。
And we'll get punished in the next life.
我们会在下一生遭受惩罚。
So Maharaj, Sukadeva Goswami tells Maharaj Parikshit, he said, there are many hundreds and thousands of hellish planets all under the care of Yamaraj.
Sukadeva Goswami 跟 Parikshit Maharaj 说，有成千上万的这样的地狱星球。
I've only mentioned some of the sinful people. There are many others I didn't mention.
我只提到了一部分这些罪恶的人，还有很多其他不虔诚的人我没有提到。
So those people who are pious, they go to the other planets, like the planets of the demigods.
那些虔诚的人会进入到其他的星球，比如说半世人的星球。
But after their pious and sinful activities are used up, they come back to earth.
当他们的虔诚或者果报活动被用耗尽之后，他们会回到地球上。
Earth is the karma, the place where we earn our karma.
地球是我们赚取业报的地方。
So, people in the mode of goodness, they go up to the heavenly planets, and those who in the mode of ignorance, they go to the hellish planets.
那些处在善良属性中的人会被提升到天堂星球，那些处在愚昧形态之中的人，他们会去到地狱星球。
But eventually, both the pious and the sinful, they come back to earth.
但无论是虔诚还是罪恶，他们最终会回到地球星球上。
So the problem of life is not solved because we still have a material body.
因此，真正的生命的问题没有得到解决，我们仍然有这个物质的躯体。
And we shouldn't be very eager to go to the heavenly planets. We should understand that's also another kind of hell.
我们不应该很渴望要去到天堂星球。我们应该知道，那也是另外一种地狱。
We should be eager to go back to Godhead to develop our spiritual body.
我们应该渴望回到灵性世界，发展我们拥有我们灵性的躯体。
Don't be pious and don't be sinful. Just be a devotee and surrender to Krishna.
不应该虔诚，也不应该不虔诚。一个人只是应该成为一个 Krishna 的奉献者。
So Krishna tells us how to be a devotee. He says, engage your mind in thinking of me, worship me, offer obeisances to me.
Krishna 描述了很简单的崇拜他的方法。总是想着他，总是崇拜他，成为他的奉献者，总是顶拜他。
So in the second and third canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, we heard about how we can make progress on the path of liberation.
在圣典薄伽瓦坛的第二篇，我们了解到了人如何在解脱之途上前进迈进。
So the universe is divided into 14 different parts, 14 different levels.
整个宇宙被分为14个部分，14个层面。
So this is like the body of the Supreme Lord.
这就像至尊主的身体一样。
Just like the Lord has a form, so the universe is also like one of the bodies of the Lord.
主有他的身，有他的身体，整个宇宙也是作为他的一个形体。
So if we hear about this and if we read about it and explain it, then we will develop our Krishna consciousness.
如果我们聆听、阅读和谈论这个的话，我们会发展我们的 Krishna 知识。
We just have to practice hearing and chanting gradually. We will awaken Krishna consciousness.
我们只是有规律的聆听和唱诵，我们会发展我们的 Krishna 知识。
So in the beginning, we cannot understand. Don't give up. Just keep hearing.
在开始的时候，我们很难理解，但是不要放弃，保持聆听。
It doesn't matter if we go up to the heavenly planets or down to the hellish planets. It's all a waste of time.
不要考虑这个去到天堂还是去到哪里，这都是在浪费时间。
We should hear about the Supreme Lord, and we should hear about the form of the Lord and how the universe is a form of the Lord.
我们应该聆听至尊主，聆听整个宇宙如何是至尊主的形象。
In this way, gradually, we can become qualified to go back to Godhead.
通过这样的方式，我们会被逐渐变得有资格回归受持。
So one who is interested in devotional service, then he's a devotee.
如果一个人对奉献服务有兴趣的话，他应该是一个奉献者。
He has to control his mind by thinking about the form of the Lord, even the form of the Lord in the universe.
他应该控制自己的心意，去冥想主的形体，甚至冥想主的宇宙形体。
First, he can think of the Lord in the form of the universe. Then he can think of the Lord in his spiritual form.
开始的时候，他可以冥想主的宇宙形体，逐渐他可以冥想主的灵性的形象。
Lord Krishna's spiritual form is eternity, full of bliss and knowledge.
主 Krishna 的灵性的形象是永恒、极乐和充满知识的。
And then we can fix our mind on that spiritual form, and we can go back to Godhead.
当我们把这个心专注于主 Krishna 的这个形象的话，我们就可以回归受持。
So we want to progress. You have to associate with the devotee. You have to find out some advanced devotees who are liberated souls.
如果我们想在这个上面获得进步的话，我们得和一个解脱的人，一个在这条路上解脱的人，和他得到他的联谊才行。
Then you get a chance to hear about the Lord. You get a chance to advance.
这样我们就会得到机会去聆听，能够得到机会去进步。
But if we get the wrong association, then we continue birth and death in the material world.
如果我们得到的是错误的联谊的话，我们会在这个物质世界不断的生死轮回。
So you want to stay in the Krishna consciousness movement, then you have the chance to hear Srimad Bhagavatam regularly.
如果我们一直保持在 Krishna 知觉的运动之中，我们就会有机会一直聆听圣典薄伽瓦坛。
So Sukadeva Goswami tells Maharaj Parikshit, he said, I've told you about the planet Earth, and I've told you about the other planets in the universe.
Sukadeva Goswami 给 Parikshit Maharaj 讲，我现在已经给你描述了地球、星球以及其他的这些星球。
I've told you about the lower planets and the hellish planets and the stars.
我也给你描述了地狱、低等的星球、地狱的星球以及这些星辰。
So this is what makes up the universal form of the Lord.
这些构成了主宇宙的这个形象。
So I've told you about the external body of the Lord.
我给您描述的是主的外在的形象。
So Prabhupada has added a little bit on the end of this chapter.
Prabhupada 在这个在二十六章的最后增加了一点点。
It's written by Prabhupada's spiritual master, Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati.
这个是圣巴圣帕帕德的灵性导师圣巴提西丹塔斯尔斯瓦吉写。
So he says that people who have knowledge of the Vedas agree that the incarnations of God are very many. There are many, many incarnations of God.
他写到，所有伟达经典的博学者都一致同意，至尊人格守神的化身是无数的。
So these incarnations are in two sections. One is called Prabhav, and the other is called Vaibhav.
主的化身可以分为两类，一类叫做 Prabhava， 另一类叫做 Vaibhava。
So Prabhav incarnations are also in two sections.
Prabhava 化身也被分为两类。
One section is are called eternal, and those which are not very clearly described.
一类被称为永恒的。而另一类被称为那些没有被生动描述过的。
In the fifth canto, in this fifth canto, chapter 3 up to chapter 6, there's a description about Lord Rishabhdev.
在圣典博迦瓦坛第五篇的第三到第六章之中，描述了主 Rishabhdev.
But there's no description about his spiritual activities.
但是并没有对他的活动进行展开的描述。
So he's considered like a Prabhav incarnation because we don't know much about him.
因此他被归属于第二组的 Prabhav 化身之中，因为我们并没有了解到他的很多细节。
In the first canto, in chapter 3, it tells about incarnations of Krishna.
在圣典博迦瓦坛的第一篇描述了 Krishna 的化身。
It said Lord Vishnu appeared in the eighth incarnation as the son of Maharaj Nabi.
主 Vishnu 以第八位化身显现为 Nabi 的儿子。
And his wife was Meru Devi.
他的妻子是 Meru Devi.
And he showed the path of perfection.Paramahamsa stage.
他展示了完美的旅程，生命的 Paramahamsa 的阶段。
So Lord Rishabhdev, he is the supreme personality of Godhead, and his body is spiritual.
主 Rishabhdev 是至尊人格守神，他的躯体是灵性的。
So we may ask, how is it possible that he passed stool and urine if he is spiritual?
我们可能会发出疑问，如果他的躯体是灵性的话，他怎么可能会排出粪便和尿液呢？
So this is answered by our great Acharya Baladeva Vidyabhusan.
这个问题被我们伟大的 Acharya 先辈灵性导师圣 Baladeva Vidyabhusan 回答。
He said, imperfect manThey talk about Rishabhdev passing stool and urine. They think this is the business of non-devotees.
那些不完美的人叫人们注意 Rishabhdev 排泄粪便和尿液，把它作为非奉献者的研究主题。
So they don't understand the position, the spiritual position.Of somebody with a transcendental body.
他们不了解一个处在超然躯体层面的超然的地位。
So in the fifth canto of the Bhagavatam, the illusion of the materialist is described.
在圣典博迦瓦坛的第五篇描述了这个年代物质主义者的困惑状态。
Lord Rishabhdev himself says, this body of mine is inconceivable for materialists.
主 Rishabhdev 自己也说，我这个躯体对于物质主义者来说是不可思议的。
Just like in Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says the same.
就像主 Krishna 在博迦梵歌中也同样的这么说。
Krishna says, they don't, I appear in a human form, But they don't understand my transcendental nature.
主 Krishna 说，当我以人形降临时，愚人嘲笑我超然的地位。
Yeah, the human body, when Krishna comes in a human body, it's very difficult to understand him.
当 Krishna 以人体的形象降临时，对于他们来说是很难以理解。
Ordinary people, we can never understand how God can come in a human form.
普通人无法根本就无法理解。
So Lord Rishabhdev, he's explained that his body is the spiritual, it's on the spiritual platform.
主 Rishabhdev 直接说，解释说，他的躯体属于灵性的层面。
So Rishabhdev did not actually pass stool and urine.
因此，主 Rishabhdev 事实上没有真正的排泄、粪便和尿液。
But it appears like he passed stool and urine.
但是他显得好像是在排泄粪便和尿液。
So this was also transcendental. It cannot be imitated by ordinary people.
这也是超然的，他不可能被那些普通人所模仿。
The stool and urine of Rishabhdev was full of transcendental fragrance.
主 Rishabhdev 排的粪便和尿液是充满超然的芬芳的。
So you may imitate Rishabhdev, but you cannot imitate his passing stool that is fragrant.
我们可以模仿主 Rishabhdev, 但是我们无法模仿他排泄的粪便和尿液也是芬芳的。
So the activities of Rishabhdev, they're not easy to understand.
因此，主 Rishabhdev 的活动是不那么容易理解的。
Some people claim they're followers of Rishabhdev, but they cannot follow Rishabhdev.
有些人宣称他们是 Rishabhdev 的追随者，但是他们无法追随 Rishabhdev.
So Sukadeva Goswami has related, he told this after he heard about Lord Sukadeva Goswami, he described about Lord Rishabhdev, and he told some important information.
Sukadeva Goswami, 聆听了主 Rishabhdev 的品之后，描述了。
There was a king. You see, when Lord Rishabhdev died, Lord Rishabhdev left his body in a forest fire, and that forest fire was in the kingdom.Of one king of Konka.
Sorry, Guru.
Lord Rishabhdev left his body, he burned his body up in a forest fire.
Guru Rishabhdev 在森林里面用火燃烧了自己的躯体。
So that forest where he left the body, that was in the kingdom of a king.
这个他燃烧躯体的那个森林是一个国王的王国。
And that king began a religion following Rishabhdev.
这个国王就开始追随 Rishabhdev, 以他为这个宗教。
But the principles were not according to the Vedas.
但是他的原则并不和伟达，就是与伟达经实际上是不相符。
Actually, it's an atheistic philosophy.
实际上它是无神论者的这个哲学。
And these people, they didn't understand Lord Rishabhdev, and they thought his activities are material.
他们并不能理解主 Rishabhdev, 他认为主 Rishabhdev 是物质的。
But Lord Rishabhdev is an incarnation of the Supreme Lord.
但是主 Rishabhdev 是至尊主的一个化身。
He's on the transcendental platform. Nobody can compare to him.
他是处在超然的层面，没有人能与他相比。
So when Lord Rishabhdev came, he's showing the activities of the Supreme Lord.
当主 Rishabhdev 来的时候，他展示了至尊主的活动。
So when he gave up his body,It was in a forest, and the whole forest was burned to ashes.
当他离开他的躯体的时候，整个森林都被燃成灰烬。
So Lord Rishabhdev also burned people's ignorance to ashes.
主 Rishabhdev 也将人们的愚昧化成了灰烬。
He was showing the activity of a Paramahamsa.
他展示了一位处在 Paramahamsa 的层面的品格。
But the teachings of this religion, people who claim to be followers of Rishabhdev, they don't actually follow Rishabhdev.
但是那些声称自己是 Rishabhdev 的追随者的，他们的这些人，他们实际上并不是 Rishabhdev 的真正的追随者。
So there's another description of a Rishabhdev in the 8th canto of the Bhagavatam also.
在圣典博迦瓦坦的 第八篇同样也会对主 Rishabhdev 有另外一次的描述。
But that Rishabhdev in the 8th canto is different from the one described in this canto.
但是第八篇的那位主 Rishabhdev 又不同于这一篇所描述的主 Rishabhdev。
Okay, so we'll stop.So next time we can go on to the 6th canto.
好，下一次我们会描述第六篇圣典博迦瓦坦的第六篇。
Okay. Any questions?
Okay. Yes, yes. 李佳莹，顶拜咕噜，感谢翻译。我有一个问题：如何选咕噜？如果根据追随经典来选择，那么是不是可以选择任意一个追随经典的启迪咕噜，然后再一群追随经典的训士咕噜就够了，然后再去，因为没有区别啊，或者是按照假我的喜好来选择，比如说我喜欢听这个咕噜的讲课，我就爱他，我就选择他。A basis to Guru Day, I have a question. How to choose a guru? This is the main point. If I follow the Shastra, then I can choose any guru that follow the Shastra. Is that enough?
Yes.You can choose any guru. You can choose anybody to be your guru who follows the Shastra.
你可以选择任何一个追随经典训谕的这样的一个人成为你的 guru.
Everybody has free will to choose the guru for themselves.
每个人都有选择 guru 的自由意志。
Have you taken the disciple course yet? Have you studied the disciple course? It teaches how to select the guru.
请问您上过门徒课程吗？
If you,
在这个里面有讲述如何选择 guru.
If you haven't, you should take the disciple course, and that will help you to understand how to select the guru.
如果你上过门徒课程的话，那个里面就会帮助你如何教会你如何选择一位 guru.Okay. Next question.
Yeah.
感恩小苹果，感恩 Guru Day， 感恩翻译和主持人。我想问，地狱中的狗等一些动物是终身都栽在地狱中吗？他们的灵魂也是从地球投身到地狱去的吗？这些地狱的动物有没有机会提升到更高的星球，最终回归守神呢？Thanks, Guru Day. I want to ask, is the dogs in the hellish plant, and any other animals, are they internally in the hellish plant?
Yeah.For the duration of the material world, remember the material world is a temporary creation, so hell is not eternal.
我们得了解到，这个整个所有的这些地狱星球，它不是永恒的，整个宇宙不是永恒的，所以地狱星球也不是永恒的。
So when the material world is destroyed, then they give up their bodies and they take another birth.
当当这个毁灭的时候，他会放弃他的躯体，然后再会有下一次的投生。
However, in the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna describes people who are demonic, who are demons, they take birth again and again in these kinds of bodies.
在薄伽梵歌中，主 Krishna 说，这些具有恶魔品性的人会被一次又一次投生到这些恶魔的地方去。
And they like these bodies. They're happy in these bodies.
他们非常，而且这些人非常喜欢他们的这个躯体，他们愿意待在这样的躯体之中。
It's the nature of material world. We get very attached to the most terrible situations.
这是物质世界的本性，我们非常依附这种很糟糕的状况。
Yeah, there's a story how Brahma, Lord Brahma was cursed by his guru to become a pig, and he became a pig.And he was living in the pig house, and he got very fat, and he had a big pig family. And then Guru came and told him, you know, okay, now you come back with me. He said, no, I like it here. It's very nice.
我们有这么一个故事，主就是英爪，天堂星宿的英爪，他被一个婆罗门诅咒之后，投身到地球上，成为一头猪。当他成为这个猪之后，他变得膘肥体壮，然后还有自己的家人。然后他的姑姑说：“好了，英爪，你现在可以回归了，你现在可以回来了。”但是这个英爪就对他的姑姑说：“不，我现在非常享受这个猪的这个情况，我非常喜欢他这个现在的状况。
”I have my pig family here. I get my pig food every day. I'm happy.
我有我的猪的这些家庭，我有我的这些猪的食物，我非常的快乐。
So Lord Brahma or the guru arranged to get a butcher to come.
然后他的 guru 就安排了一个屠夫来了。
And the butcher came and he said, "Oh, let's get the big fat pig. We'll cut that one up."
这个屠夫就说。让我们来把那头最肥的猪给挑出来，然后把它给剁了。
So Indra changed his mind. He said, "Oh, take me, save me."
然后 Indra 就改变了心意，说：“哦，我的 guru， 请救我，请救我，我想回去了。”
So the guru was merciful. He got Indra out of the hellish condition.
他的姑乳是非常仁慈的，把他从这种地狱的状况中给拯救出来。
But not everybody wants to get out. The people just want to stay there. They stay many births in these horrible situations.
但并不是每一个人都想从他地狱的状况中回来的，他们在自己的这个状况之中一直待着，他就喜欢。
下一个问题。
Second part in this question, he asked, "Are this dog the soul of this dog? Is coming from the earth plane to the hellish plane?"
Yes.
是的。
This earth planet is where you earn the karma.
在这个地球是我们获得业报的地方。
You either go up or go down or come back.
无论是去到上面还是去到下面，我们都回到这个地球上。The third part is, are the dogs in the hellish plant, are there have any opportunity to elevate to the higher plant and then finally go back to the Godhead?
Yeah.
是的，他们会有机会。
After a long time.
但是很长很长的时间。Next question, Guru. Next question from Rajendra Prabhu. 感谢 Maharaj， 感谢亲爱的翻译。去过地狱，经历地狱的惩罚，现在遗忘，甚至不相信有地狱，如何恢复这个记忆？Thanks, Maharaj. I've been go to the hellish plane and experience the punishment in the hellish plane. But now I forgot everything, and even I'm not believe there are hellish plane. My question is how to recover this memory.
Read Srimad Bhagavatam.
通过阅读圣典《波迦瓦坛》，你可以恢复这个记忆。
This is all told in the Srimad Bhagavatam just to help us remember.
圣典《波迦瓦坛》的这一切就是为了让我们记忆起，帮助我们记忆起这一切。Rajendra Pop, next question is, 人们害怕死亡，是否与有过地狱经历有关吗？He asked, people are afraid of the death. Is that any connection with the experience of in the hellish plane?
Well, we have died many times in many different situations.
我们死过很多次，而且有很多种不同的死法曾经。
But the usually we understand we're afraid of death because the nature of the soul is eternal. The soul never dies.
我们之所以，但是通常的情况下，我们之所以害怕死亡，是因为灵魂它是永恒的，灵魂从来是不死的。
But we're not identifying with the soul. We're thinking we're the body.We've made the mistake. We're thinking I'm the body, but we're not the body, we're the soul.
我们从来都是不认可自己的这个灵性的身份，我们总是认可自己的身躯体，但是实际上我们是这个灵魂，我们不是这个躯体。
Because we're conditioned souls, we're attached to eating and sleeping, mating and fearing. And the thing we're most worried about is fearing.
因为我们是受条件限制的灵魂，我们总是很依附吃睡防卫和交配这些活动，我们很少去害怕。
No.
Sorry, Gurudev.
Eating, sleeping, mating, and fearing. Defending is fearing.
Oh, okay. 我们总是吃睡交配，而防卫就是害怕的一种本能。
Right? So the big problem is fearing.
最大的那个问题是害怕恐惧。
Yeah, everybody's afraid. We're thinking I'm going to die, but actually we're all souls. The soul never dies.
每一个人都害怕死亡，但事实上我们是灵魂，灵魂是不死的。
So we have to change the consciousness.
因此我们要改变我们的知觉。
Devotee is not afraid to die because he dies to live.
奉献者不害怕死亡，因为他的死是为了活着。
When we get freed from the material body, we get our spiritual body.
当我们离开这个物质的躯体的时候，我们会得到一个灵性的躯体。
Yeah.
顶拜 Gurudev， 这个是喜浪的翻译，喜浪的问题。顶拜 Gurudev， 感谢翻译。一个不纯粹的奉献者在修习的过程中，有可能对他人仍有许多冒犯，死后是去地狱受，死后也去地狱受到惩罚吗 ？Obeisance to you, Gurudev. A devotee are not pure devotees.When he practicing this bhakti yoga may offend many other people. So when these devotees die, this devotee will go to the hellish plane to get punishment?
No, before the devotee dies, he has to ask forgiveness for all of his offenses to the devotees.
在这个奉献者死之前，他应该向所有这些曾经他冒犯的这些奉献者寻求他们的原谅。
Prabhupada did that.
Prabhupada, 圣帕帕德就是这么做。
His godbrothers came to see him And Prabhupada begged them for forgiveness.
圣帕帕的神兄弟来看他，圣帕帕的祈求他的原谅。
And everyone who is a devotee, they will naturally say, "No, no, no, you didn't offend me. No, it's okay. No bad feelings."
任何一个奉献者应该都应该不应该有非常好，就是说有这样的想法，不应该有就是把这个事情怀恨在心，没有关系，这一切都OK，没有冒犯。
So we have to know the etiquette. We have to understand the etiquette, how to have proper relationships with all the devotees.
我们也得理解，我们也得学会如何和所有的这些奉献者保持一种好的关系。
Every day we offer obeisances to devotees.
每一天我们都向奉献者顶拜。
And certainly, before we leave the body, we beg forgiveness if I've offended you in any way.
在离开躯体的时候，我们也请求这些奉献者的原谅。
But devotee won't see hell. Devotees, they're always under protection of Lord Krishna.
奉献者总是在主 Krishna 的保护之下。
Krishna says, "My devotee will never perish."
主 Krishna 说，我的奉献者不会受到惩罚。
Yeah, 还有问题吗？
Yes, next question from Rajendra Babu. 罪恶的人去地狱接受阎罗王的审判，时间多长？ 投胎下一生需要多久? The sinful people go to the hellish plan. How long they will get the punishment? And how long he will go to the next life?
Well, it will depend on their sin, how much sin they did.
这一切取决于他们犯了多少的罪恶。
It will depend on how much they need to be punished to get rid of their sinful mentality.
这一切都得取决于他们需要多久来惩罚结束他们的这些罪恶的活动。
Lord Yamaraj is the god of death. He knows the nature of these different sinful people.
就是Yamaraj知道这些罪恶的这些人的这些本性情况。He
knows what is their consciousness and how much sinful they are.
他知道这些人的知觉，他知道这些人到底有多大的罪恶。And
he knows how much somebody is sorry for his sins and how much somebody is not sorry.
他知道一些人他到底是对他的这些罪恶心怀愧疚呢，还是一点都不感到愧疚。
So people who do more sins, they will get more suffering.
人们做越多的罪恶就会遭受到越多的痛苦。 Next question from Amy. 顶拜亲爱的Guru，顶拜翻译。首先祝Guru身体健康。如果家人有像Guru所说的很看重金钱，很会理财，但又担心自己的这些钱，我们应该如何帮助他们呢？因为下地会被逢真是多么可怕呀！感恩Guru. Obeisance to dear Guru and first, I want to wish Guru Mahaguru body health. if my family is like the Guru said in this today in the Srimad Bhagavatam, they say the money very important, and they are also worried about this money. So how can we help them? Because in the Hellish Plan, they suffer a lot. I want to know how to help them.
Well, generally we help sinful people by chanting the holy name and by giving prasada.
通常情况下, 我们帮助人们是通过给予他们圣名, 给予他们prasada的方式。
And try to educate them about spiritual knowledge.
试图给他们一些灵性的知识。
And you can also help them if you become a pure devotee yourself, then you can deliver your family. Just like Prahlad Maharaj, he was born in a family of demons. His father was very demon. He fought with Lord Narsingadev, he tried to kill Lord Narsingadev. But because Prahlad was a pure devotee, all of the family, all the ancestors, they all got liberated. So you can liberate your family also.
Next question.
Yeah.
Next question from Shenyang Bhakti Yu Yue Hong. Yu Yue Hong. 顶拜亲爱的Guru, 感恩顶拜翻译, 首先祝Guru身体健康。 亲爱的Guru,人间地狱和宇宙地狱有啥区别? I want to, from Rajendra Prabhu, the hellish in the earth, what's the difference between the hellish in the human earth and the hellish planet in the universe?
Well, the hellish planet at the bottom of the universe, people go there, they get more punishment, it's much more severe.
在这个宇宙底部的这个地狱，人们如果去到那个地狱的话，人们会得到更多的惩罚，人们遭受的痛苦是更多的。But
and generally, they go down to that earth, the hellish planets, the bottom. They go in the subtle body. They don't have the gross body. They're just in the subtle body, but they feel the pain like they have a gross body.
人们去到那个星球，他们通常不会有粗糙的躯体，他们只会有精微的躯体。但是他们感受到的痛苦，他们感受到自己好像是有一个粗糙的躯体。But
on the earth planet, they have the gross body.
但是在地球星球上，我们有的都是粗糙的躯体。And
of course, there's also hell on this planet here, but you know the generally the time. Span is not very great here.
The time is.
Yeah, we don't live very long in these hellish conditions.
在这个地球上, 我们通常待的这个时间也不会很长。
Yeah.
Yeah. Next question from Bhakti Yuyue Hong. 顶拜亲爱的Guru,顶拜翻译,首先祝Guru身体健康,人在死亡和到地狱的过程,灵魂是在什么时候离开粗糙躯体的呢?感恩Guru. Obeisance to Guru, I wish Guru body health. When the people die and then he go to the hellish plant, when the soul leaving this gross body?
At the time of death.
在死亡的时候离开.
At the time of death, the soul leaves the body. At that time, the subtle body goes with the soul.
在人死亡的时候，人离开这个，人离开这个粗糙的躯体，这个精贵的躯体和灵魂在一起。
And for the sinful people, the Yamadutas come and they rip the soul out of the body.
对于那些罪恶的人，亚玛都塔会来，他把这个灵魂从这个人一下子就给逮住，逮出来。
And they drag him down to hell to meet Yamaraj to get punished.
他们把这个灵魂拽到地狱去见 Yamaraj。
Mm-hmm.
Next question from Shamasaki. Shamasaki, David Dasi. Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Gurudev 和所有的奉行者。Vasudeva 向主把他们的罪恶的 karma 转移到他身上，宁愿自己承受他们的罪恶反应。主说，你想拯救宇宙的所有生物体，那么甚至不用你经受罪恶活动的磨难，所有人都能得到拯救。我想知道才讲的地狱中的罪恶灵魂是否还有被拯救的机会。 OK Hare Krishna, obeisances to Gurudev and all the devotees. Vasudeva Datta asked the Lord to get all the sinful reactions karma to his body. But the Lord said, you want to save all the living entities, so you no need to get this all the sufferings, but everyone can also get liberation. So I want to know, you mentioned that today in the class, these sinful soul, are there have any opportunities to get relief?
Yes, I said they can get released.
是的，我说他们可以得到拯救。
We will hear in the sixth canto it describes about sinful Achamil. He was to go to hell, but he was saved from going to hell.
我们会在圣典博迦瓦坛的第六篇就讲述到，比如说阿迦米勒，他被带入到地狱，他本来应该去到地狱，但是被拯救。
He chanted the holy name of the Lord, and he was free from all of his sins.
他唱诵了主的圣名，然后他从所有的罪恶活动之中得到了解救。
It's what you have to do. You have to chant the holy name. You have to practice chanting every day.
你得唱诵主的圣名，你得每天练习唱诵主的圣名。Next question from Yasho David Dasi. 顶拜 Gurudev, 顶拜翻译和主持，我想问被启迪的奉献者，如果犯了很大的错误或者冒犯了高级奉献者，但是后来很愧疚并且改正的错误，直到离开躯体都不会再犯同样的错误了，并努力做服务修习 Krishna 之觉，这种情况下有没有可能下地狱呢？如果还有可能下地狱，怎样才能得到救赎不下地狱呢？ Obeisances to Gurudev, I want to ask if the devotees initiate when he get a big offense or make a big mistake, offense to the higher class devotees, but he feel guilty and will not do this fault again. And he try hard to do the devotional service, practice Krishna consciousness. In this condition, whether he will go to the hellish planet or not, if possible, he will go to the hellish planet. How can he not to go there?
Well, he needs to get the mercy of a pure devotee and hold on to the lotus feet of the pure devotee.
你得得到纯粹奉献者的仁慈，你得抓住这个纯粹的奉献者。
Take up the activities of devotional service. Chanting the holy name is the process for this Kali Yuga.
抓住奉献服务的这个程序，这是给予这个卡利年代的程序。
If you chant the holy name constantly, then you'll never have to see hell.
如果你能持续不断地唱诵主的圣名的话
You'll never see hell.
哦，如你不会去，你不会去到地狱。
And if you take shelter of the holy name, even if you do go to hell, it will become like heaven.
如果你抓你托庇于圣名的话，即便你去到地狱，那也是天堂。
Hell becomes heaven for a devotee.
地狱会因为有奉献，对于奉献的人来说，那里变成了天堂。
You just have to take shelter of the holy name. There's nothing else.
只是托庇于主的圣名，主的圣名没有别的。
And serve the devotees.
服务奉献者。
Give service to the devotees. Try to please the devotees.
服务奉献者，试着去取悦所有的奉献者。Next question from Yovati Vishaka, Dimbai Gurudev. 这一生修习 Krishna 之觉，不断地做奉爱服务。临终时想不起 Krishna 怎么办呢？ Obeisance to Gurudev. All this life practicing Krishna consciousness and do the devotional service. But at the end of life, I can't remember Krishna. What happened?
Krishna will remember you. Even you can't remember Krishna at the end of life, Krishna will not forget you.
即便你想不起 Krishna, Krishna 会记得你的。
And Krishna will come in your heart and take you back to Godhead.
Krishna 会来到你的心里，然后把你带回手身。
Yeah.How you went to?
Next question from Yasho David Darcy. 丁拜故人感谢翻译和祝。如果妈妈和孩子是奉献者，爸爸不修习 Krishna 之觉，但是爸爸让孩子去给别人送烟酒肉等东西当礼物，孩子应该去送吗？在这种情况下，有可能下地狱吗？ Obeisance to Gurudev. If the mother and the child are the devotees, but the father are not practicing the Krishna consciousness.Somehow the father asked the child to give the meat, wine, and cigarette as a gift to the other friend. So, other child should to deliver this gift or not? In this condition, the child will go to the hellish plane?
The child is better not to give these things to anybody.
孩子不应孩子不应该把这些东西给予任何人，就是说不应该把这个东西当礼物去送这个礼物。
Better to refuse to give these things to people.
最好不要，最好拒绝吧，拒绝这个事情。
Yeah, everybody, just like anybody who kills animals.Then everybody involved in the killing of the animal and transporting the meat or cooking the meat, they all get the karma.
就像一个人杀一个动物的话，无论是送这个肉的人还是买这个肉的人，只要是涉及到这个里面的这个人，都会有业报。
So we're very conscious to avoid karma.
我们应当小心地去避免这个业报。
We don't have anything to do with this meat and alcohol and cigarettes.
我们sorry,
we don't touch anything to do. We don't have anything to do. We won't touch anything with meat, alcohol and cigarettes.
我们不应当去接触这些烟酒肉这样的一些东西。Then she asked, in this condition, the child will go to the hell?
Well, you get some karma.
当然你会获得一些报应，一些业报。
Don't want to do it, but the bad karma is going to take away your taste for devotional service.
这个不好的业报会拿走你做奉爱服的品味。
You'll lose interest in Krishna consciousness.
你会失去对做奉献服务的兴趣。
And you'll think it doesn't matter. Doesn't matter if we chant. It doesn't matter if we are vegetarian. You think it's not important.
然后你就会想着念不念诵都没有关系，吃不吃素也没有关系，这一切都不那么的重要。
Yeah, it will have an effect.
我们会有这样的一些反应。
下一个问题。
Yeah, 下一个问题来自于 Amy。 顶拜 Guru， 人离开躯体前就像乌龟脱皮那样痛苦，这个时候痛的都念不出圣名了，也是很有可能。我们应该如何正确对待呢？感恩 Guru， Guru 保证 注意身体。 Obeisance to Guru， When we leaving the body is very suffering, at this suffering time, we can't chant the holy name. It may be possible, we can't chant the holy name. So how can we do?
Well, we can hear the holy name. Have devotees come.
聆听圣名。
Have devotees come and chant for you.
我们让奉献者来为你唱诵。
We can have chanting box, Prabhupada's chanting.
我们有圣帕帕德的这个念诵机。Okay, finish. Santi Mataji.
How you went, Ma?
Hare Krishna. 没有问题了。
Oh, okay.所以今天到这。
好，非常感谢Guru Maharaj给我们的讲课和耐心的解答，非常感谢奉献者的聆听。那我们今天课程就到这里结束了，也非常感谢 Swami Roy Prabhu 的翻译。
Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai.
Jai. Good.